Marvin Pence Gaye Jr. was an American singer, songwriter, and record producer. He aided in shaping the sound of Motown in the 1960s, starting out as an in-house entertainer and later as a solo recording artist with an abundance of hit songs, earning him the nicknames Prince of Motown and Prince of Soul. When 1984 came about, Marvin was neck-deep in disaster. He owed a great deal of money to the IRS, and he was declining rapidly into a life of drug addiction and abuse. All of his relationships failed, and he was becoming more and more paranoid. He confided to his band that he was being hounded by murderers, and started wearing a bulletproof vest. Marvin was staying in his parents' house on April 1, 1984, in the Crenshaw district of Los Angeles. Marvin was scattered, doing tons of cocaine and watching pornography. He was sporting a bathrobe that he'd been wearing for several days. He toted a pistol in the pocket of his bathrobe, and had a small weaponry underneath his bed. He was absolutely positive that he was going to be murdered. On Christmas Day 1983, Marvin gifted his father an unregistered 38 caliber Smith & Wesson pistol, to arm his father against the people he thought were after him. As stated by multiple sources, Marvin had a tumultuous relationship with his father, Marvin Gaye Sr. Marvin Sr. often told his children, quote, "I brought you into this world, I can take you out." It's said that his father abused Marvin as a child, and was resentful of his fame and glory, but still survived off of the profits. The following are direct quotes from Marvin's mother, Alberta. "That morning, my husband came walking through my bathroom door, and asked me where he could find this insurance letter. I couldn't hear him very well, so Marvin asked him to come into the room where we were. My husband said no, he wouldn't come in the room. Marvin told him, 'If you don't come in now, don't you ever come into my room again.' Then my husband came in the room. Marvin told him to get out, and got up from the bed, walked over to my husband, and pushed him back. Marvin pushed him a couple of times. My husband turned and walked back to his bedroom. Marvin followed him, yelling little cuss words at him. Marvin told his father, 'I'll beat you up.' Both men went into the father's room. Quote, 'I didn't see what happened in the bedroom, I heard my husband say, "He's kicking me. I don't have to take that." When I entered the room, my husband was on the floor, and Marvin was standing a short distance away. I took Marvin by the arm and led him back to his room. I sat him on the foot of the bed. Marvin told me, "Mother, I'm going to get my things and get out of this house. Father hates me and I'm never coming back." I was standing about 8 feet away from Marvin, when my husband came to the door of the bedroom with his pistol. My husband didn't say anything, he just pointed the gun at Marvin. I screamed, but it was very quick. He, my husband, shot, and Marvin screamed. I tried to run. Marvin slid down to the floor after the first shot. The first 38 caliber slug had entered the right side of his chest at a 30-degree downward angle, puncturing the right lung, heart, diaphragm, liver, stomach, and left kidney before stopping against his left flank. It was an instant, lethal shot. Marvin Sr. moved forward and fired a second shot at point-blank range. He then walked downstairs to the front stoop, tossed the pistol onto the lawn and sat down while he waited for police to arrive. Marvin Gaye Jr. was transported to the California Hospital Medical Center, and declared dead at 1:01 p.m., one day before his 45th birthday. Marvin Gaye Sr. was arrested, and quickly, crowds of thirsty onlookers assembled in front of the family home. Marvin's remains were taken from the hospital to Forest Lawn Glendale, where an estimated 10,000 people passed by his open casket. Marvin was dressed in one of his costumes from his final tour, a white and gold military uniform. Stevie Wonder sang at the service and Smokey Robinson and Dick Gregory spoke. Marvin's mother bent over the casket and kissed his cheek. He was later cremated, and his family scattered his ashes at sea. During his first police interview, Marvin Gaye Sr. claimed that he did not mean to kill his son, but that he was scared that he would be hurt and only shot him in self-defense. When the police questioned if he loved his son, Gaye Sr. quietly told them, quote, "Let's say I didn't dislike him." Marvin Gaye Sr. was swiftly charged with first-degree murder for the death of his son. Marvin Sr. was taken to the Los Angeles County Jail, and was held on $100,000 bail. In time, the bail was reduced to $30,000, and Marvin Sr.'s estranged wife Alberta posted his bond. Aware of Marvin Sr.'s declining health, doctors examined him and located a benign walnut-sized brain tumor in his pituitary gland. The brain tumor played a factor in preliminary hearings of the trial against him, with his lawyers claiming that the tumor might have played a part in Marvin Sr. killing his son. In the end, the judge ruled that Marvin Sr. was competent to stand trial and that he knew what he had done. When the results of Marvin's autopsy showed that he had traces of cocaine and PCP in his system, taken days before his death but not active in his system, and when pictures were shown of Marvin Sr., taken after he was brought into custody, showing injuries from his final fight with his son, Judge Gordon Ringer let Marvin Sr. enter a plea bargain. Marvin Sr. pleaded no contest to a charge of voluntary manslaughter on September 20, 1984. During the sentencing hearing on November 20, Marvin Sr. was permitted to speak. Through tears, Marvin Sr. told the court, quote, "If I could bring him back, I would. I was afraid of him. I thought I was going to get hurt. I didn't know what was going to happen. I'm really sorry for everything that happened. I loved him. I wish he could step through this door right now. I'm paying the price now." Marvin Sr. was handed a 6-year suspended sentence and 5 years of probation for the shooting death of his son. Also, he was forbidden from owning any firearms or consuming any alcohol for the rest of his life. At the same time, Alberta Gaye was filing for divorce after 49 years of marriage. Alberta Gaye passed away from bone cancer 3 years later. Marvin Gaye Sr. died of pneumonia in October of 1998.